I'm John Sophocleus, and I'm from Beauregard, Alabama.
Now, is it true that you are a professor of economics?
Guilty.
All right, I just wanted to make sure that was correct. So, I'm sorry, but do you mind if I ask you a couple of questions?
Not at all.
Awesome. So, how did you first find out about Ron Paul?
Ron Paul first came onto my radar screen a couple of decades ago when you started reading some of the stuff out of the Von Mises Institute and the stands that he made on the floor of Congress as a champion of the Constitution.
And what are the most important issues facing the country today?
Well, I'm pretty much fundamental basics, property rights, taxes, reduced regulation. Anything that takes away the liberty of our citizens is deleterious. Furthermore, I never really knew how important my civil liberties were until I saw them taken away one by one.
Right, so you believe that Ron Paul is able to get these back and he's going to help?
He's the only answer for the executive.
All right, and how many presidential elections have you voted in?
The first election I was able to vote in was 1980.
Wow.
I've voted in every one ever since.
Nice. And with what political party do you identify?
Well, currently I'm identifying with the Republican Party because Ron Paul is about the only thing that could possibly draw me in to the Republican Party. And really, the Ron Paul candidacy is setting down the framework for the Republican Party to actually do what it says. They've been pretty accomplished liars for about 150 years, and here's a guy who you can, you know, I always loved the words of Ronald Reagan, didn't care for his actions. Here's a guy who's going to give you the words, and you know when he gets into office, is going to give us the actions. He's not going to increase the debt per capita 300%. He's going to keep FICA and Medicare and all that other sort of stuff in control, and heaven forbid, maybe even back it off a little bit. And give the government back to the people. That's what's supposed to happen.
Right. Well, thank you so much for the interview.
Delighted.
Thank you, Mike. Next on our agenda is Reverend John Killian speaking for the Ron Paul campaign. In 1861, Alabamian William Lowndes Yancey stood to the podium in Montgomery, Alabama, to introduce Jefferson Davis with the cry, "The man and the hour have met." This afternoon, I wish to say that we're in a precarious hour. Uncertainty abounds as our federal debt continues to climb. Our borders remain porous. The dollar worth less on the international market than in over a generation, and our own tax dollars spread across the globe and in our own country on cockamamie schemes with no constitutional authority. We see treaties, legislation, and executive orders constantly proposed and enacted which would hand over our national sovereignty to international authority.
No.
Yes, the hour is needing. Yet with hope in my heart, with uplifted voice, with amplified cheers, I wish to stand with a throng of patriots, ever growing and increasingly fervent, to announce that the man and the hour have met. The hour is now, and the man is Ron Paul!
Yeah!
Who is Ron Paul? The man who keeps winning the afternoon debate call-in polls. The man who is winning a majority of pre-election straw polls, and the man who finished among the top four, the top tier in Republican presidential candidates in fundraising in the past quarter. First, consider Ron Paul the person. Ron Paul is a medical doctor. While never accepting federal benefits, has spent untold hours helping the poor without charge. Ron and Carol Paul are the proud parents of 5 and grandparents of 17. A believing Christian, Ron Paul led the Texas delegation in 1976 for the greatest president in our lifetime, Ronald Wilson Reagan. In fact, Ron Paul was only one of 4 congressmen to endorse Ronald Reagan in 1976. Former Treasury Secretary William Simon said that Ron Paul is the one exception to the gang of 535 on Capitol Hill. Whenever some legislation passes with only one no vote, you can count on it that it was Ron Paul questioning the constitutionality of that legislation. But let's consider Ron Paul the platform. What does Ron Paul stand for? As a congressman, Ron Paul never voted for a tax increase. Did you hear that? He never voted for a tax increase. Ron Paul never voted for an unbalanced budget. Ron Paul never voted for a congressional pay raise. Ron Paul has never taken a congressional junket to travel overseas. Ron Paul has never voted to increase the power of the executive branch. And listen, Ron Paul has never voted to surrender American authority to the United Nations. Never one time, not one time, has Ron Paul voted to limit the rights of citizens on gun ownership. Your strongest Second Amendment pro-gun candidate is Ron Paul. Ron Paul doesn't participate in the congressional retirement program. Listen, Ron Paul has introduced legislation to abolish the IRS and end the federal income tax. Dr. No, due to his opposition in spending that's not specifically authorized in the U.S. Constitution. Wouldn't you just love to give the veto pen to Dr. Paul, Dr. No, to really get serious about limiting the size of government?
Yes!
If you would, Ron Paul in the poll today. What difference does this poll make? I submit to you that if Ron Paul can win this straw poll, the news media and the public will have to take notice that in a day of shifting values and uncertain ideologies, they'll know that a growing number of citizens still believe in abiding in the United States Constitution.
We believe it!
If you vote for Ron Paul today, you're saying no to Democrats and Republicans who will spend taxpayer dollars without restraint. You'll be saying no to the ever-spiraling increase in the size of government. Hear me today. If you vote for Ron Paul, you'll be saying no to the NAFTAs, the GATTs, the North American Unions, and control by the United Nations. When Ron Paul raises his hand to take an oath of office, the New World Order comes crashing down.
Bring it down! Bring it down!
Today you can vote pragmatically, or you can, once in your life, make a powerful statement. A statement for American sovereignty, a statement for the Constitution, and a statement for liberty. Join with me in standing tall, standing for conviction, in lifting high the principles of our founders and the principles of Reagan by voting today and February the 5th for Ron Paul! Receiving zero votes, Tom Tancredo. We had one vote undecided, which represents 0.5%. Dr. Hugh Court got one vote, 0.5%. Sam Brownback got one vote for 0.5%. Senator John McCain got three votes, 1.5%. Duncan Hunter got five votes for 2.5%. Mike Huckabee got eight votes for 4%. Mitt Romney got 16 votes for 8%. Rudy Giuliani got 18 votes for 9%. Fred Thompson got 31 votes for 15%. And our winner of the Jefferson County straw poll, Ron Paul, 115 votes.